Hello students, in this class we will study about the heterotrophic nutrition in plants. We all know that the plants are green in color because of the chlorophyll, and because of that chlorophyll only they are autotrophic in nature. Autotrophic means they can prepare their own food. Most plants on earth are green plants, but there are certain plants which do not contain chlorophyll, neither in their leaves nor in any other parts like cactus. As the cactus has green part, or you can say chlorophyll in its stem, but some plants are there which are not having chlorophyll at all. Such plants, which called non-green plants, are unable to manufacture their food. So the mode of nutrition in which the non-green plants are not able to prepare their food, and they retrieve their food from any other plant or any other thing, is known as heterotrophic nutrition. So in this session we will study in detail about the heterotrophic nutrition in plants. There are four types of heterotrophic nutrition: parasitic plants, saprophytic plants, insectivorous plants, and symbiotic plants. All these plants, four type of plants, are heterotrophic plants. That means they cannot prepare their own food. But out of these four, these above two, parasitic plants and saprophytic plants, these two are fully heterotrophic in nature. But the rest two, you can't say that they are fully heterotrophic in nature. That means they prepare their own food, but some part of their food they retrieve from any other means. We will discuss about it in the next slide in detail. So first of all, we will study about the parasitic plant. As you can see here, one plant is wrapped over another stem. This wrapped plant is known as the parasitic plant. It is amarbale or the dodder, which is an example of the parasitic plant. Some plants do not have the chlorophyll, hence they cannot synthesize their food by themselves. Such plants are known as non-green plants. Those who are not having chlorophyll, they are known as non-green plants. They depend on the other organism for food. Such plants use the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Some of them are called parasites. A parasite is an organism which lives on or inside the body of another organism and take shelter and food from that organism. That means a parasite is that organism which depend for its food on any other organism. The organism on which this parasite is dependent, that organism is known as host. In this case, the host is always at loss. That means it always lose something. The parasite accesses its food from the host body, and in return it causes harm to the host body. Plants that do not have chlorophyll are called non-green plants. Plants which live on other plant for food are called parasitic plants. So in this case, the dodder or the amarbale is the parasite, and the stem of the another plant is the host. So what do you mean by the parasitic plants? Those non-green plants which are unable to make their food and they live on other plant for food are called the parasitic plants. Now the next type of the heterotrophic plant is saprotrophic plants. What are saprotrophs? Saprotrophs are non-green plants. For example, agaricus, which is commonly known as mushroom. Everyone has seen mushroom, na? That is a type of fungi. Yeast and bacteria, these all are the non-green plants which are saprotrophic in nature. Why they are known as saprotrophs? Because they get their food from dead and decaying organic matter. They grow on the decaying organic matter such as cow dung, wood, bread, etc., and take their nutrition, or you can say food, from that decaying matter. Saprotrophs secrete digestive juice over the decaying material and absorb nutrients from them. What it means that the saprotrophs secrete the digestive juices and digest the material outside their body, then they absorb the digested or simple form of the nutrients from that decaying material. This is called saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Such plants are called saprotrophs, and the example is mushroom. Next category is of insectivorous plant. Insectivorous plant means the plant which eat insect. As you can see here, it is the pitcher plant and this one is the sundew plant. Some plants eat insects. Such plants are called insectivorous plants. They trap and digest the insect. Pitcher plant is the example of an insectivorous plant. This one is the pitcher plant. In pitcher plant, the leaf is modified to form a pitcher-like structure. As you can see here, the leaf is modified in a pitcher-like structure. Pitcher means, you can say, a pot-like structure. The bright color of pitcher make it very attractive to insect. Inside the pitcher, there are several hair-like structure. These hairs direct the trapped insect downwards. When the insect sits here, the hairs trap them and move it downwards. When an insect sits on the pitcher of the plant, the lid closes. This is the lid and it closes when the insect is trapped in it. The insect gets trapped inside the pitcher and the insect is then digested by the enzyme secreted by the cells of the plants. So, insectivorous plants are not totally heterotrophic. Why? Because they are green in the color and they can prepare their own food. They eat insect only for fulfilling their requirement of nitrogen. So you can't say that insectivorous plant is fully heterotrophic plant. Another example which is shown here is of sundew. In this also, the insect sit on the two halves of the leaves of sundew, and when it sits, the leaves get closed and the insect get trapped inside the leaves. So insectivorous plants are those plants which eat insect to fulfill their requirement of nitrogen, but as well as they are autotrophic also because they are green in the color, having chlorophyll, and are able to prepare their own food. The next group of the heterotrophic plants are symbiotic plants. Symbiotic plants are those plants which show a phenomena which is known as symbiosis. What is symbiosis? It is a combination of two Greek words. Sym means with and biosis means living. That means in this type of combination or in this type of relationship, two plants are living together. In symbiosis or mutualism, two different types of organisms live and work together for their mutual benefit from each other. They share shelter and nutrients. In this condition or in this relationship, both organisms get benefit from each other. Not like the parasite, in which only parasite is getting the benefit and the host is always getting harm. But in the symbiotic relationship, both the organisms which are involved in this relationship, both get benefits from each other. The example is lichen. What is lichen? It is a composite organism composed of fungus and algae. As you know that the fungus is a saprotroph, it can't prepare its food. And algae is a green plant. It is green in the color and it is having capability of preparing its food. So in this combination, fungus is a saprophyte and algae is an autotroph. The fungus supplies water and mineral to the cells of the algae. And it attached with the host plant or it with the base, that means it provided shelter also and supplies water and mineral to the cells of algae. And with that supply, algae prepare its food by the process of photosynthesis, and in return it provides nutrition to its fungal partner. So as you can see in the lichen, which is the example of symbiosis, or the which is a symbiotic plant, both fungus and algae are getting benefits from each other. One is providing nutrients and another is manufacturing food for both. Another example of symbiotic relationship is found between the leguminous plant and rhizobium bacteria. What do you mean by the leguminous plant? Plants which having pod like structure of food fruit, which is the leguminous plants having their fruit in the pod like structure. The example is pea, etc. So what is important or the special about this leguminous family plants? The legumes form a unique symbiotic relationship with bacteria. As you can see here in this picture, it is the root of one leguminous plant. It's in the root of these plants, these nodules are found. In these nodules, one certain type of bacteria, which is known as rhizobium bacteria, it is living. As you can see here, it is the root and it is the nodule, and inside this nodule, the rhizobium bacteria is present. Now, how it is beneficial? The rhizobium bacteria is a special type of bacteria which convert the atmospheric nitrogen into ammonia and mixes into the soil, which can be utilized by the plant for its growth. As you know that though the nitrogen is found in abundant amount in the air, but then also plant cannot directly utilize it from the air. They need this nitrogen in the form of its compound mixed in the soil. So the rhizobium bacteria, which is living in the root nodules of the leguminous plant, it convert the nitrogen of the atmosphere into its compound like nitrates and mix into the soil and make it available for the plant. And in return, the plant provide food or nutrients to the rhizobium bacteria. So you can see a symbiotic relationship between the leguminous plant and rhizobium bacteria. This So in this way, we have studied about the four different types of heterotrophic nutrition. That's all for this session. We will meet in the next session with more informations.